I'm a Lin H. Manheist Professor in Engineering and Wireless Distinguished Achievement Professor. I'm going to show you that how wood-based electronics can change our world and benefit the state of Wisconsin. So we use cell phones every day since the last several decades. So we really need it in today's life because we can use it for staying connected with the friends, families. We can use it for learning, for entertainment. We can also position ourselves when we're going to get lost. We use cell phone for security, for your house, for everything else. And we can use it for banking and financing. We also use it for shopping, for healthcare, for travel, planning, whatever. There are lots of things we can rely on cell phones. So this is really the modern life will look like. Without a cell phone, we can't imagine how our life would be like. However, we need to know that, you know, the most important thing that the impact of mobile phone technology on economic growth is really critical because the mobile phone industry accounts for 1.5% of the world GDP. And for the mobile technology accounts for 60% of the revenue of the telecommunication industry. So absolutely, a cell phone is very important. It not just to give our easy life, it also sustain our economic growth. However, we also pay the environmental price for the using cell phones. Why is that? Because the average American people buy a new phone after every 18 months in average. So this results in about 100 to 120 million phones that are still useful but discarded every year. This is just for in US only. So with this amount of the phone to be discarded, you can imagine that how much waste we are going to, electronic waste we are going to generate. So many of the materials used in the cell phones are hazardous materials. And then they clog our landfills and also pollute our air. And then our groundwater will be also put at risk because we discard so many phones. So what we can do to enjoy this using the cell phone while also maintain the economic growth, and then we also minimize the environmental impact. So basically, this is what my research program is about. So in Wisconsin, we have a huge resource in forestry. So basically, the forestry in the state of Wisconsin, so we have 17 million acres of forest lands and millions of urban trees that significantly enhance the quality of our state. And can we use this wood to do something that to link this wood economics to the cell phone industry? So this is really I'm looking for the last 10 years. So this is what we have been doing, and then we have been very successful using wood to enhance or replace these expensive materials of cell phone electronics. So basically, how can we benefit the cell phone industry with the wood? So this chart shows that if we have a way to use wood as the substrate, which is the substrate that we use in our cell phone, and then eventually we can make a cycle, using this wood and then make this wood into very nice substrate, and then using this substrate to build the electronics, and after we use it. Used up, life ended for the electronics, and we can, discard it easily without harm to our environment. This is the goal we want to do. So on the left side, you can see that we have found that we have used the wood, derived the substrate, which is called cellulose nanofibril, and then we have made beautiful chips that are as good as the regular chips you find in your cell phones there. So this is the way. This is the way. Really, we feel like to solve this dilemma that we really rely on cell phones, and we also want to minimize the environmental impact. So this chart will show that if we could do make this cell phone chips using wood substrate, we can reduce the release of the toxic materials to the environment by 500 times. And we can also reduce the use of rare earth materials. And rare earth materials, as you know, they are not renewable. and then by up to a 5,000 times. So this is really significant. So basically, we have been able to show that by connecting wood, and that is abundant in state of Wisconsin, to electronics, and then we can gain so many advantages. So after this chip, and you know, reach their end of life, or someday before the end life, is reached, and we want to discard the old phone, buy a new phone, and how we can degrade, discard this phone. We do not need. We will not generate toxic materials. We will not, make the landfill, clog our landfill. Instead, we can put in our yard and then disassemble it, put the chips into the yard, and then let it degrade. And then fungi will eat up these chips, and then the only material that left is basically a new fertilizer. And then we can easily collect these very, very tiny, precious materials, and then from the landfill. The other way to recycle the things, basically, we can easily just burn out these chips or the cell phones. And then you can see, as you can see, in 7 seconds, a useful functional chip, we can easily just burn it. So this is really the way to link this state of Wisconsin advantage and to the electronics industry and generate a lot of impact. So how is Wisconsin benefit from wood-based phone chips? So as you can see on the left side, because Wisconsin has an ample resource for wood, and we set up a forest product lab in 1910. And then if we have been working with this forest product lab, basically it's funded by agricultural department. And then what we will be able to do is we can advance the technologies together with FPL. They have been developing beautiful substrate I've showed before, and we can make more wood products. We will be able to make phone chips, we can also make computer boards, and then we can also make cell phone cases, even computer cases. So we will eventually, we hope to tie the wood industry with the electronic industry to continue to push the economic growth while we minimize the environmental impact. So we will be able to, train more workforce, and then we will be able to create more industry companies, and we can create more jobs. So in the meantime, we will be able to reduce the use of natural resources, that's like rare earth materials, and in the meantime, we will be able to save our environment. So this is really a message I really want to deliver to you, and then to show that what kind of research we have been doing at the University of Wisconsin, and how we can benefit the state of Wisconsin, and then also benefit the rest of the world. Thank you.